Welcome to Lords of Xulima, I believe it's how it's pronounced. I will probably say Xulima a lot. Anyway, intro video.
My world was dying. I was called forth by one of the nine gods to set sail for Xulima, their homeland, where no mortal had ever tread. But they had already abandoned it, and their new lords awaited my arrival to claim my soul.
I'm sorry, Xulima. I am going to butcher that a million times. Anyway, lords of, well, you can read, locks, let's just say. This game is a game that I've been looking forward to for a little bit. I was going to do it, and then it's like, oh, yeah, I gotta do my Magic 10 first. But anyway, here we are. New game. We could play on normal. We could play on hardcore, but we won't. Or, you know, normal, easy. One of the key differences is HP and PP power points that you gain in the game for your characters. On normal, one of the characters gets like 18 points a level. Which means nothing until you what I tell you what they get on old school. 6. Hardcore, it's even less. So, let's go for old school veteran.
So deep was I sleeping that I felt as if I were drowning in the darkness and silence, as if time itself had stopped. I was on the Isle of Brina, far from the great war that consumed the grand continent of Rodinia. I heard a voice whispering in my ears, and I felt as if my body was being lifted up. I could not open my eyes, but I could see the firmament clearly, as if I had been pulled up to the stars.
Galen, hear the voice of Golod, the architect, the master of dreams and constructor of matter. The world is in agony. The guardian of souls is gaining power over the lords of Xulima. Our strength diminishes. I have watched you from the stars. I have chosen you to be my herald, my hand on Earth. You must complete the mission I am giving you. Eradicate the evil that profanes the divine temples of the creators. Gather your party and sail to Xulima, where no other men from the West have set foot. Let the currents of Naliet and the breath of Taliet guide you to your destiny.
The voice trailed into the stars, like a whisper carried away on the winds. Finally, I was able to open my eyes. Had it all been a dream? I wished it were so, but I knew it was real.
Yes, anyway. Creating party. We are going to create our own. This is Golan. He's the gentleman in the intro cinematics speaking. You're stuck with him at all times. So there. Anyway, we're going to create a male character. It's going to be that gentleman. And he is going to be a barbarian. Why do I obsess over these things? Let's go with the sea. Yes, gods. These are nine gods. Xulima. Yeah, I'm gonna push at that. Disciple of Naliet. 5% extra HP. No, that actually isn't very good. Combat speed plus 5%. If you don't know what to pick. Pick this one. I'm not kidding. Combat speed is, well, it's really important. Curse Kit, plus 3 strength. Velvet, plus 4 agility. Evasion, plus 10. Not very good. Raznet, combat initiative, plus 15. That's useful for any character that does buffing. We're playing a barbarian, though, so that's really not that important. Experience gain plus 4%, that sounds really good. It's not. I've done a lot of reading on this game, so yeah. I've only really played the first few hours of the game several times, just to see, to figure out what I'm doing and what I want to do in reading. I would definitely read about character creation, party creation before you do this. Maximum power points, 5%, same as the HP one. And that, which basically gives you 3 resist to everything. Not useful. I mean, it doesn't matter now. Later it will. As a barbarian, however, you would think, you know, strength, maybe agility, or combat speed. Those 3 are pretty much your choices for this character. We are going to go with Velvet, though. Weapons do different things. Axes can cripple your opponents, as you can read. Makes it harder for them to hit you, and I believe they do less damage as well. Maces can stun the enemy, which, yes please, and swords cause bleeding, which is additive, which is pretty nice. I'm going to go with maces, however. We're going to create another male character, and there is an option to add portraits, like from this guy down, our portraits that I added, there is something somewhere that you put pictures into, they have to be the right size, and the file needs to be named right, and blah blah blah. So you can put in pictures of anything you want. Yes, even that, you dirty pervert. This gentleman, actually. Let's have a soldier. You can be Maxwell. You're also going to do Velvet. Bows? Yeah, not as much as axes. Don't pick that. Pole weapons? Act like maces, but not as well. And, well, yeah, we're going to go maces. It's better to concentrate on one thing. Create a new character. This person's going to be a woman. Let's see. Who looks right for this role? And I would use that if I was having a female barbarian. That picture right there. Let's go with her. This lady is going to be a thief. And I suppose I could look at this. It tells you initial skills, attributes. That really shouldn't matter. This lady is going to be called Xulima. She is going to use Talliot. And this option only picks on what you start with. Like, I can pick up a dagger now, and it's actually a pretty good idea since thieves are kind of fragile. And daggers apparently give a little bit more parry. Apparently. She is going to switch to swords, though, but I want to start with a dagger. It's going to be another woman. It's going to be this woman. And it's going to be a Divine Summoner. Divine Summoners, you really should have some foreknowledge before creating one. They're a little bit complicated, but that doesn't... The best comparison I can make for a Divine Summoner is a Pokemon trainer. Yeah. She, however, is going to be Raznet. Divine Summoners are pretty much worthless without their summons. They really are. And getting them out earlier is better. She's going to take up a pole weapon. Last character is also a woman. Let's see. Debating on that one. Or this one. Let's go blue hair. This lady is going to be a... well, I suppose I should discuss the things. Bards do a lot of buffing. That's what they do. Barbarians hit things really hard. I was actually a little bit tempted to name mine Hulk. You know, Hulk, Smash, Mace. Yeah, I don't... It's funny. The pity laugh, yeah. Soldiers, it's a soldier. They can learn like skills and whatnot, like special attacks. Barbarians really can't. They don't need it though. They get an ability that causes them to crit more often. Hulk, Smash, yeah. Anyway, Cleric is apparently pretty much mandatory. Again, I haven't played that far in the game, but apparently they are pretty much mandatory. Divine Summoners, Pokemon Trainer, yeah. Paladins in this game are not a cleric replacement. They do their own thing. They do get healing spells. However, you can't compare the two. Arcane Soldier is pretty much widely agreed as the worst character. Some people argue Divine Summoners, they're using it wrong. they get this spells like a mage does and abilities as a soldier does, but there's not enough skill points, and they get them really late. Mage, pretty obvious. Thief, pretty obvious. Where were we? Cleric. This woman is going to be Kaylin. She is... do I want to go Taliot? Well, initiative doesn't matter for a healer. Evasion doesn't matter. She's going in the back row. Yeah, let's go combat speed and pole weapons. With pole weapons, my Divine Summoner, my Cleric, can hit things from the back row. Physically. It's not really important for them, but it's nice to have the option. That's why they're picking it up. If they could use bows, I would go that direction instead. Now, let's see. Gollan, Marduk, Maxwell, Julia, Astra, and Kaylin. Yeah, let's go.
It was said that it was to be the darkest and bloodiest age in the history of man. On the great continent of Rodinia, the two largest kingdoms began a great war that would drag every country and village into an endless stretch of death and chaos. Many begged and prayed to the gods for help, but the gods never answered. In the safety of Brina, a small island in the far east of Rodinia, the echoes of war thundered louder with each passing day. In those ill-fated times, those who govern our destiny decided that I, Xulima the explorer and navigator, would do my part to shape history. So I was chosen by Golot, the master of works, to be his herald on Earth. In that time, I understood very little of the true meaning of those grave and profound words. The gods, who once lived on the lost continent of Xulima years ago, were engaged in battle with the Guardian of Souls. And as their power waned, the power of their enemies waxed. Golot commanded me to sail to Xulima, and once there, liberate the sacred temples of the divine. Little hope remained in the world, as long as our Lord Protectors continued their battles beyond the distant stars. Without them, nothing could stop the ruin of Rodinia. And so, it was then that I gathered my allies and set sail from Brina to the east. The wind and the currents guided us across the vast ocean of Morovia. The clouds and the mists were our constant and only companions. 2 weeks later, the clouds divided, and at last we felt the light of the sun once more. And there it was. Beyond the horizon, the land of legend. Xulima, home of the creators.
You notice a lot of loading screens in this game. They're quite frequent. Most of them are actually really short. This is pretty much the longest one that I've encountered so far. Movement, WASD. We have, Talisman of Galat. Yeah, that's it's a DLC. A lot of people call it paid cheating. Whatever. It's not something you can use willy-nilly. Anyway, except for Gollan, everybody in this party is basically a lump of stats. If I go to Astra, I can change her photo. She can look like that woman. Yeah. I don't like that, but there's nothing I can do about it. It's just one of those things. There's a button up here in the corner. You can hide that. That's really bad, because down here is your food meter. If you run out of food, you start starving. You don't die from it. However, you take massive penalties in combat. Gathering food is actually really important in this game. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to... Come on. There we go. Want to run. Also, notice time's elapsing. Yep, basic tutorial. Get a little bit of gold. Yeah, from what I've played of this game so far, this game is unforgiving. And I'm not even playing on hardcore. No. No. Yeah, plant collection, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I can collect these mushrooms, and eventually those mushrooms will... No. And, yeah, journals, really important if you forget stuff. You can, you know, mental resistance, cold resistance, you can get these. However, you're better off not doing it right now. Golem gets an ability. Where is it? Knowledge of herbs. Obtain 1 to 1.7 doses of every herb. Normally I'm not one to min-max. However, once you fill this out, you put points into this every single level until you max it out. Go back and do it again. Because at 29, it's something like 3 or something that you collect of each herb when you do a little thing. At 30, it's something like 5. It is a massive increase. It's well worth the trip back. And again, normally I'm not a person for it. I'm not, you know, min-maxing, but it's a lot of stats that I could possibly get. Food and rest. Food is really important. Sleeping is really important. People don't... I don't think in this game they get really tired, but I really haven't noticed so far because I've been having to rest to recover wounds. There are lost hit points, and then there's mortal wounds. You can die. However, resting for 24 hours fixes that. It's a game, just accept it. Food, however, I will collect. And it tells you how much you have left. This, however, is a little bit misleading. This means that I have 1 day and 6 hours. It says I have 2. But it's 2. This is the second day. Little bar. I don't know if I properly explained that. But yeah, it's something like that. More little mushrooms for me to collect later. I haven't actually gotten to the point of collecting them. And yeah, there is really well hidden stuff around here. A little bit more food. There is a lot of food collection in this game. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to edit out as far as combat goes either. I don't know how much editing's going to be done with this. This game's going to be a long game. Really long game. It's just one of those. Wonder if they know anything about Rodinia. Now, if you right-click on a set of enemies, like these soldiers, difficulty Titanic. Take that word to heart. No, really. If it says impossible, it's impossible. It's very, very truthful about it. I don't know about later in the game, but especially in this part, it is very truthful.
Cannot pass.
Why not? A toll? $100 gold for a period of time. Needless to say, at some point, I want to smash this guy's face in. However, he's using a mace, as you might notice. And you'll also notice that when I right-clicked on him, it wasn't just him, there were 4 of them. Yeah, 4 of them chain-stunning you? Yeah, You must pay the toll. Yeah, I'm not gonna pick a fight. He already mentioned the 100 gold, so I'm not going to ask again. And I don't have the money.
Go away.
It's not very nice. not at all. Yep, little mushrooms. There is, you know, that back there. That's well hidden. There's much better hidden stuff than that, trust me. Being curious in this game definitely pays off. We should be able to get into our first combat of the game. Balanced. It's balanced. More mushrooms. And something I'm going to warn you about right now. That little fireplace, don't walk over it. You take damage. Yeah. Also, you notice when I mouse over him, he shows the little wheel thing pattern over him. If you walk into that circle, you'll be in combat. As the tutorial is nice to mention. Anyway, first combat of the game. I am probably going to get my face beat in. Yeah, it is a turn-based system, but it's free-roaming. It's a little bit of... Oh no, I didn't do something. Marduk is supposed to be here. Julio is where she belongs. Astra is supposed to be there. Kaylin is supposed to be over here. Trust me about this. Julia really doesn't have the option to do anything. I mean, I have, and trust me, inventory. I'm going to have to get used to that. I'm going to really have to, no, let's not do that. Pay attention to my inventory. Inventory is really important in this game. Absurdly so. 8% chance to hit, 3 to 4 HP. Now, where Julia is, she can hit this guy and this guy. She can't reach him. Gollan is unfortunately not very good at melee. He's actually best over here to protect Astra. He's really good at just taking damage. That's pretty much all he's good for at this point. Later on, even more so. Yeah, remember the Pokemon trainer comment? Yeah. Summons heralds. They have different abilities. Raznet smashes things in the face. He does have a reach though, so even if I summon him back here, he can't hit them. Nalliot, however, is a healer. Kaylin might need a little support. She doesn't last forever, though. Nimona does not last forever. She has a certain amount of turns. 37 seconds, which isn't really important. It's to do with over here. This is important. Make your plans accordingly. Gollan is going to switch with Marduk. Block. Good. Excellent. And that is the stun mechanic. The stun mechanic is wonderful. It also gives you a 100% chance to hit. Anything that's stunned, you have a 100% chance to hit. Not to mention, that guy's turn gets pushed back further. That's why I went maces. Julia, however, is not using a mace. She doesn't have the option. She's gonna go bleeding. I don't really have a choice. I need a thief for how I plan on building this party. However, she has the ability to use shurikens, which cause a whole lot of bleeding effects. Yeah, I'm not using that on this combat, unfortunately. I wish I could show it, but I'm not going to. Yeah, she has light heal. Nimona is going to take care of a lot of the healing early on. Kaylin doesn't really have a really good PowerPoint pool at the moment. Later, she gets an ability later that's absolutely fantastic. Again, 100% chance to hit while stunned. Absolutely wonderful ability. And you can fail and hit yourself. Good job, Gollan. let's summon Raznet. Or Batten. I kind of want to call him Batman, I'm not even gonna lie. Critical hit. Those are nice. You're stunned. Which is nice. Kaylin, you don't really need to do anything, however. And that stun added to it. So instead of being pushed back, so, you know, say his was 1... He would have became a 3 from... Was it Marduk or Maxwell that hit him? I don't even remember. It doesn't matter. Then, you know, the 1, so he becomes a 4. Can't reach him. Ah, 1 HP a turn. Swords do that better. Yeah, that, I guess that's that parry. And yeah, pneumonia, yes, pneumonia. We're calling her pneumonia for the rest of the game. Oh, boy. Oh, really, Astra? I'm surprised. Oh, you're way down there. I don't know how long that stun is, though. Nah, figures. Yeah, the game can kind of screw you with RNG, can't it? With the constant stuns. Golem can't do anything. Too bad. Enemies can move, just like I can. Like I switch Golem and Marduk. Most melee enemies don't do it. Ranged ones constantly. However, you can make them waste their turn, especially with casters. It's kind of a good thing. 36 experience and 42 gold. What do you really expect from our first combat? Loading times are a little bit longer than I'm used to. They actually are really short without my recording software going. They're not too bad. There's lots of little ones, which I like. If you're going to have loading screens, I'd much rather have little small ones, even if there's like 15 of them in an hour. That's fine. If they're just a couple seconds, that's fine. Got a poor cloth suit, some boots, and 200 gold coins. Not that bad. First thing I want to do is fix this problem. That's the way I want them set up. I will probably never move them. These two spots are for Astra's summons. I did pick up some items, however. Defensive 12. This is the maximum amount I carry. 34 kilograms. I have 6.6. Strength increases it. Constitution, I think, increases it too, but not as much. I mean, it makes sense. Just because you can pick something up doesn't mean you can carry it for a long period of time. I think it makes sense. Strength? There you go. Agility, which is nice. Speed, which is pretty much the best stat you can put points into. Because it affects how frequently you take your turn. Because the turn taking is your speed versus your enemy's speed. So more speed's better. You pretty much 100% guarantee you will be putting a point into that every single level. And energy, he can't even get. And it's not important anyway, because he just smashes things face in. Anyway, defense. Let's see, let's give this to you. And yeah, there is a weight thing. If you go over it, it's penalize the character's speed. That's, you definitely don't want that. 13, and let's give you the boots. With how I have people up, set up, Julia and Golan are going to get hit the least frequently in this lineup, melee-wise. Marduk and Maxwell, in reverse that, are going to get hit the most, just because they're in the middle, they can get hit by everything. So that's that. Now I can enter the town and loot it. Because I don't know what these guys planned on, but all of them coming essentially naked? Probably a bad idea. Hello, sir. Very well.
Go away.
I don't know how long that takes. How long before it seems inconsistent before he goes, hey, you have to pay the toll again. But I'm sure there's some rules for it. Another thing that's very important, it's kind of min-maxing, but it's important to the food. If I walk over here, watch the time. Now if I walk along the path, it goes a little bit slower. The slower this goes, the less food you consume. Well, you still, you know, travel the same... Oh, I didn't know that was there. Sweet! Let's just take all of that. especially early on, I don't think there's a create food kind of spell in this game either. Anyway, let's talk to this gentleman.
Good day.
Master and trainer. Oh, yes. The, Xulima. Xulima. Is, very isolated from the rest of the world and the war that's going on. Well, let's just skip over that. Yeah, the kind of taking my money thing. In the temple, the earlier the intro cinematic, the text mentioned that the temples of the gods has been profaned. No. He must, not knowing of the other land, he must be looking at us like, what rock did these people come out of under? So, the sons are the evil ones. The original king, a kind man, passed away after the creators have left. This is the beginning area. You will not die as horribly. There will be death. There is no way I'm going to play through this game and not get game overs. No. I know, there is one other person who I got this game for, because they were interested in it. Yeah, he kind of rage quit. I know he's looking forward to this. Hi! Yeah, new journal event. A little bit of story. Let's see. You can improve your abilities through training at skill points, something we haven't gone over yet because I haven't leveled. It's not important. You can't use them unless you're in the level up screen. Something you need to remember. At this point, it's 100 gold coins. A little bit strapped for cash at the moment. Job postings. 200 experience and 400 gold coins. Yes, please. Gotta start somewhere, though. I will go. We'll talk more to that man in the next part. Save game, write all over that. Ignore the old saves. Next time, we'll talk more to that man, explore the town, and loot everything I can find. The chest that's over here, though, that was new to me. I did not know that was there. That's good, though. And we have some torches, it gets dark. Consumable, healing potion, person drinks it, they heal. Healing salve, it's the same thing, but you can use it on a different person. Yes. Anyway, there's a lot to do in this game. Let's not try to force too much into the first part there, RPG. But next time, more wandering around. Hopefully this came out alright. Until then.